sweet. They're gonna knock me off my feet. A lot of kisses on the bottom. I'll be glad I got them. I'm gonna smile and say, I hope you're feeling better. Enclosed with love the way you do. I'm gonna sit right down and write myself a letter and make believe it came from you. Smile and say, I hope you're feeling better. Enclosed with love the way you do. I'm gonna sit right down and write myself a letter and make believe, make believe, make believe.
Zink.
Here.
Kurt Gerdin. Tip Kung.
Here.
Scott Hopkins.
Here.
Courtney J. Miller.
Here.
We have a quorum.
All right, great. Is there anyone from the public wishing to address the board for an item that is not on today's agenda? Seeing no one, I will close public comment and move to item B, which is the approval of the minutes. And this was our previous meeting on May 12th. Do I have a first and a second for that?
First
by Scott, second by Tip. Thank you very much. Moving on to the minutes of the previous meeting. Anything before item one? Item one. Item two?
No. Nope.
Item three. And item four. I have one comment or question for staff. Item four is the new restrooms that was at the boathouse, Henry's Beach. And is it going to go to the City Planning Commission or the County Planning Commission? Because it said it was referred to
plan. To my knowledge, it's the City Planning Commission. I would have to ask Pete Lawson. The footer says Planning Commission, so. And I was under the assumption it was the regular planning commission. Let me find out.
Oh, sorry, Kathy, yes.
Sorry, that's Kathy Kennedy. We're going to just place a quick phone call to her.
You can just, my only curiosity question, if it goes to the City Planning Commission, can you inform ABR so one of us can be present?
Oh.
Because
we would ask you. We would ask somebody to represent the board at that commission meeting.
Okay. Yeah. I think it's important in particular for this one project.
Okay.
Because of our comments.
We'll make sure.
All right. Welcome. Anything else?
Nope.
All right. So if there's no other comments, I'm going to call for a vote on the minutes of the previous meeting. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Abstentions?
Abstain.
One abstention.
Who abstained?
I did.
Kirk? He walked in late. No big deal. Moving on to the consent calendar for May 19th. Is there someone who would like to first that?
First.
Scott? Second by?
Second.
Courtney? Good.
Those items were item A, 320 West Pueblo Street was final approval as submitted. Item B at 706 East Haley was continued 1 week to consent with comments.
Okay. Any other discussion? If not, I'll call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Motion passes. Moving on to the consent for today, which is May 27th. Do we have a first and a second?
First.
First by Courtney. Second by?
Tip.
Tip. All right. Thank you.
And those items reviewed today. Item A at 1934 Elise Way was granted project design approval and final approval as submitted. Item B at 706 East Haley Street received final approval as noted. Item C at 118 North Milpa Street was granted project design approval and final approval as noted. And item D at 3761 State Street, also project design approval and final approval as noted. Those were reviewed by Commissioners Gradine and Miller. I mean, board members Gradine and Miller.
Great. Any other discussion? If not, I'll call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. We are moving on to announcements, item D. Are there any announcements?
Mr. Chair, board members Poole and Witosh will be absent today. And due to a conflict in meetings scheduled for this room, today's meeting will need to be concluded by 6 p.m. So staff is asking board members to be succinct in their comments and to try not to repeat comments that have already been voiced by other board members. And that's all I have.
Great. Moving on to subcommittee reports. Just curiosity. Scott, do you want to make an announcement or shall I about the...
Please do.
Wonderful. I didn't prepare this at all. Scott and I met with city staff dealing with the Southern California Gas Company wanting to put those wireless... cell
meters,
sites,
the meters
throughout the city. We reviewed all of the site locations. They changed a few of them. We reviewed one of their photo sims, and we basically said that this is the direction, the package that they need to present. They're going to come back to us as a subcommittee with photo sims for all of the locations in town, and once we basically feel that they work within our opinion, we'll bring it back to full board, and then they will do... the city as well as the gas company, or maybe just the gas company, will announce it to the neighbors, notify the neighbors, so that people have an opportunity to come back to the board and comment about the project. So that's our subcommittee report.
I have one also. I attended the, not really prepared for this either, but the Arts Advisory meeting this month. They just discussed a couple of items, including the business license requirement for artists and the Douglas Lochner sculpture at the
airport,
which may come back to us because there was some question about signage. So that's it.
Okay, great.
I have one thing to report as well, although I'm not prepared. this was an appeal of the People's Self-Help Project on Salsa Puedes, and the appeal was not supported by City Council, so it was denied, just to let the board members know.
Yep. Anything else for subcommittees? If not, let's move on to item one of the agenda, which is 3328 State Street. This is a new project, so I'm going to read the project description. This is a proposal for a streetscape facade remodel on an existing 3,161 square foot one-story commercial building. No other changes are proposed on this 6,750 square foot lot. Requires staff hearing officer review for a zoning modification. And projects comments only. Requires environmental assessment and staff hearing officer review. I have your name for the record and your presentation.
Sure. My name is Jonathan Viegas. I'm with Dark Moon Building Design Engineering.
Okay.
I'm the designer and the engineer on this project. It is just a kind of an updated facade that more closely resembles Loretta Plaza across the street, kind of a more Spanish style. And we are reducing the amount of clear frontage windows here. So.
If you don't mind, let's go through the site sure. photos first and then explain the mod, and then you can go through the elevation and site plan.
Okay.
So instrumental music directly across the street from Loretta Plaza.
Correct.
And point out anything you want to. If there's a little portico share.
Yeah, this is the area that we're actually removing. So the metal facade, that's kind of the metal mansard roof. And we're basically leaving the soffit in place because it would be too costly to take it down and rebuild it for the owner. So we're going to square it off and use it as part of the architectural element for here. And again, we are reducing the storefront windows, so to have arches in the front. And that's basically it for
site context. Mm-hmm. No removal of landscaping?
No removal of any landscaping. There's hardly any to speak of, so.
Okay.
Unfortunately.
Great. Let's look at that on TV. So at the front, no change to the door layout, just a change in the thickness of the mullions.
Correct.
Creating the arch pattern.
That's correct.
And this is the existing overhang, and that'll continue over here.
Yeah, this is actually the property lines, and
oh.
the existing overhang is shown more on the elevations. I don't shadow it.
Okay. Anything else you want to add to your presentation?
The plaster color. I didn't bring a color board, but we're gonna match the color of the Loretta Plaza plaster across the street as well.
Can you explain what the mod is?
The mod is because on this side of State Street, basically any building that's over 15 feet tall, any changes to the front need a modification. So since this is greater than 15 feet, and we're adding this kind of signage facade up here, then that triggers the modification. And actually, the existing parapet is higher than 15 feet anyway. So if we did the stone surround piece right here, then that also triggers the modification. So that's why we're trying to get the modification to add those architectural accoutrements to this building.
And what was staff's comment about the mod?
It was supportable.
Okay. Anything else?
No, that's it.
I'm going to open up public comment. Oops, I'm sorry, staff comments.
No, that's okay. I just wanted to let you know that you will need to make the compatibility criteria analysis up here.
Okay.
In your comments to the staff hearing officer.
All right.
So, thank you.
I'm going to open up public comment. Is there anyone from the public wishing to address the board on this project? Seeing none, I will close public comment. Does staff have anything else?
I do not.
Okay. It's back to the board for questions of the applicant. Anybody at any order?
Questions. Just for clarification. So the mansards right now, it's, can I use the pointer there?
Oh, sure.
It's coming almost to the tip of this overhang and then sloping back.
Correct.
So you're removing that.
Yes.
And then this, what's determining this parapet height? Is it?
That's existing parapet. And so we're just adding the stone crown molding around the side of it. So.
Okay. On this drawing, it looks like these are the same surface, but actually it's stepping back right here.
Yeah, well, we're actually going to bring that so it is flush with that surface here, so we don't have this sort of jog in the roof element. So we were going to actually bring that out, so it is flush on the side.
The 3D model show it then?
Yeah, it might show it that way. As you see, we're bringing it out, so it's flush along here.
So this currently doesn't exist right here? You're filling that in?
Yeah, it steps back a little bit right here.
And what's the reason for that, for bringing it out flush, as opposed to just matching the offset that you've got happening in the front?
It's not the same offset. It's just like a little, like only like about 4 inches or so.
Okay.
So.
And okay, and this is more like a foot and a half or so?
It's like 2 feet, 2.5 feet, yeah.
And then the part you're popping up, is coming out 6 inches or so. Do we know what that dimension is? Or?
Yeah, about 6 to 8 inches. So,
and it's
just to give some sort of reveal.
Uh huh. Okay, and then it kind of looks the way you've drawn this. I don't know if it's just the manner that you've drawn it, but it looks like this column is not going all the way through the glass? Is it stopping the glass, or are you leaving the glass in place? Or what?
We're leaving the glass in place, and so it just becomes kind of like an infill. So the glass is kind of an infill there. So.
Okay. So how would you finish that wall that's right against the glass? There's enough of a gap there that you'd plaster it or something? Or
We haven't got to that point yet.
Okay.
So.
All right, those are my questions. Thanks.
Those are good questions.
Mm-hmm. Scott? Is that a stone that you're showing on your elevations at the base of that?
Yeah, it's I think it's a limestone. So. Okay.
And then is this some applied stone on that piece there?
Not an applied stone, but kind of a different textured and a little bit of a reveal of a stucco.
So it's a different texture of the plaster?
Yes.
Okay. Those were my questions.
I have one more.
Go for it.
So it looks like the sidewall is block, but on your drawing it looks like it's the same texture. Are you planning to plaster that?
Yeah, exactly. We're going to be plastering it so it matches the rest of it.
Okay.
There.
Questions from other people? If none, and you can just jump to comments. And this is for staff. Compatibility and then modification, positive comments for the modification or our concerns if we can't support it.
I can start?
Yeah.
So I find this project just a little bit troubling, and I'll tell you why. The existing building, I wouldn't say, is an architectural masterpiece by any means.
Sure.
It doesn't have anything really to do with Santa Barbara. It's not a bad building per se. I mean, it has a logic to it, and it seems the pieces fit together. There's a few things that you're doing that I don't quite see the logic in. And the first is maintaining this existing canopy or protuberance there. I don't think it's helping the composition. I'm not sure why. I guess it's a little bit more money to take it off, but given all you're doing, it would make sense to me to remove that. Because two things. One, I don't think it's working with the arches. Mm-hmm. The arches don't make sense. And when it kind of the rubber hits the road, this detail of applying the arch to the glass, I think is problematic and troubling. And if it were up to me, I think I'd just keep it as one big storefront, because it just seems like an applique. It doesn't, architecturally, when you build that, I think it's going to be a really messy and complicated detail, and I think you'd be happier in the end if you didn't do that. And I think the building may be happier as well. The colors are another area that I think needs work. It feels like a lot of beige happening. And the manner in which you've done the signage, I don't think lends itself. It doesn't align with the arches below. It seems kind of floating in this elevation, maybe centered between here and here. But this, I find troubling. It's kind of a big box warehouse signage technique on a very small building.
Oh, excuse me. The sign will be reviewed under a separate permit.
No, I understand that.
Okay.
There's an architectural element that the sign's attached to. Thank you. So that's something I would reconsider as well. So you know, my big trouble points are the arches. I don't think it makes sense. I don't think it makes sense to leave this canopy. I think this area is problematic, and the colors need some tuning up. So I would say the project needs some work.
Okay.
Somebody else? Either the same comment or different comments?
Yeah, I do agree with all the comments from Scott. It needs some work.
I will.
Go ahead.
I will agree. I'll take a slightly different approach. I mean, it needs work. If you were to keep this because the client wants to keep this, then you need to add some architectural, I hate to say enhancements or something to make this thing look like it's appropriate to the architectural style. Just leaving it the way it is doesn't work. So if you want to keep it, then put some beams out there to make it look like it's supporting it and make it part of the architectural solution. Also, filling this thing in seems disastrous, and it shows, I didn't catch it here, except I was missing the hard line because this is way far in the back, but seeing it in the 3D model, I think that in some respects you're making the building worse by filling this corner in, even though you can't see it from the pictures, three-dimensionally, the form is awkward.
Oh, okay.
So it needs help in how you go about it in one way or another. That's up to you as the designer. I also think it's a incorrect solution to try to leave the glass in here and plaster on both sides, because what happens when someone breaks the window? So it needs some tweaking and some design work.
Okay, thank you.
Could staff redefine the modification? I'm still not really clear on what it's for. Can you comment on that?
Then let me check and see if I have it. Hold on. Is the front of the building within the front setback?
It is. It's
okay,
within.
Okay, that's, they're modifying the roof. Are you raising the height of the building?
Not raising the height, but any of the changes are above the 15-foot limit. So
okay,
that's
so they're making changes to the roof within the front setback.
Okay. I don't have any differing comments.
Anything, Clinton?
I agree with everything that's been said.
Okay, if someone wants to wrap this up into a motion, and then we can make an indefinite continuance back to full board.
All right, I'll make a motion. The board appreciates the notion of bringing this building, redesigning the facade to improve it. However, the facade presented doesn't meet the standards of Santa Barbara yet.
Okay.
The applicant should consider removing the arches or handling the arches on the facade in a different way. The board's concerned about the applique nature of those arches. Leaving the existing canopy as it stands now isn't an acceptable solution. Either remove it or enhance it in some manner. Come back with the revised color scheme and the pop-up element on the elevation appears to be not cohesive with the rest of the building. Consider an alternate way of doing that. And the alignment that happened on the, I guess that's the south elevation, popping it out, does not appear to be enhancing the building. Any other comments?
I'll second that motion with under discussion.
Yes, under discussion.
Scott's mentioning of the existing canopy. If we could just add to either remove, I think you said that, either remove or redesign.
Redesign or enhance.
Okay, I'm good with that, yeah.
Your discussion, Scott, would you be willing just to say under color scheme that just to have him bring a color samples and leave off that the comment that what he is proposing isn't working?
Yeah.
Premature. I mean,
I felt that way just after I said it.
All right, cool. All right.
And then, staff, I have a question for you. This project is being presented to us by a designer and a construction firm, and it's not a licensed architect associated with the project. Can you check later to see if that's going to be okay? Because this is structural enhancements and exiting and ADA issues.
I'm a licensed civil engineer.
Oh.
Yes.
I'm sorry. I didn't see that.
But I believe you need to be a licensed architect for a commercial project.
Yeah, or
civil, okay. Okay.
I'm actually in the process of getting my architectural.
Oh, good for you.
All right.
Three tests away. So.
Three tests away.
Yeah.
What do you think?
It's Mr. overrated.
This is Suzanne Riegel. She's actually the case planner for this.
Do you want to briefly go over the mod just because there were some questions asked?
So the project is located in the SD2 overlay. And because of the building's height, the front setback in this area is 20 feet. The existing building is legal nonconforming to the required setback. So if we make any alterations to that building within that required setback, it does need a modification. It's fairly technical in nature. He's not encroaching any further than the existing storefront. But we look to the board for comments on the aesthetic appropriateness of that improvement.
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
Given that additional input, could we also ask the applicant as part of our comments to show where the setbacks are on the floor plan and site plan?
Yeah. So if we can add that to the minutes, I would say if we could show like the back of curb and then we can see how much sidewalk there is, and then if it's 8-foot sidewalk, if it's more than 8-foot, then maybe there's an opportunity that we can add some landscaping in the front. I know at where BevMo is located, that used to be sidewalk that went all the way up to the building, and we asked them to cut that away, and then they put landscaping in there that didn't require watering or much watering. So there's opportunities, perhaps, depending on where the curb is and how much sidewalk is currently existing.
One more comment. If you could also show the dashed in the overhang of the existing canopy, wherever that occurs on the plan, so we can clearly evaluate that.
Sure.
Any other discussions? If not, this is for indefinite continuance back to full board. I'll call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. We'll see you when you're ready.
Okay. Thank you. Thank
you. Okay. You can keep that set.
Okay.
Moving on to item 2. Seen this project before. This is 122 South Voluntero Street, Ontario. Hello, you can introduce yourself. We're waiting for the plans in the previous minutes.
Okay, I'm Eric Swinnemson, designer, and Aaron Carroll, landscape architect.
Okay.
Staple there.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Do you have a presentation in mind? Or should we go through the minutes?
I can go through the minutes. I'll just go into the minutes.
Oh, there we go. So this was last reviewed 2/18, February 18th. Continued indefinitely with the following comments. Number one, provide a landscape plan and location of the trash enclosure on the site plan. Include site fencing details.
Here's the trash. Let's go to the landscape plan.
Double trash enclosure. And then some details and stuff. I got it.
Is this different than our set?
Just the detail sheet. My word, you really have detail sheets.
Staff, have you noted that
new sets are being substituted?
Only landscape sheets I've seen.
Okay.
And it's just the addition of the details. And
details.
Stuff.
And this is
the sheet. So we're not replacing any sheets, you're just adding sheets?
Correct.
Or you're replacing?
Just
adding sheets.
Adding.
Yeah. Okay. So next sheet, we have the fencing detail. So for the side yards, rear yard, we're matching the existing dog ear fence. It's in good shape back here. And in the front yard, we're doing a low picket fence and also a new gate. And then here's the trash enclosure detail as well.
Okay.
Mr. Chair, just to back up a little bit, I'm not sure all board members are familiar with the overall design of the project because they were not present for this project.
Who was absent at that last one? Or does it say when the vote was taken at the bottom of those comments? Motion carries Hopkins and Whitosh.
7-0.
So everyone was here.
Okay.
Well, let's just go through the minutes and then we'll...
Yeah. So number two is consider replicating the detailing and character of the front house, particularly on the east elevation.
Let's go to the elevation sheet. Elevation of the existing house.
Well, you'll have to look at the photos. I didn't draw them.
Okay.
You have the photos.
Staff will get them for us in a minute.
So photos from the previous.
This elevation look matches the photos that we'll see shortly.
A lot of the elements are quite similar. Yes.
Number three, provide more architectural character to the north elevation.
Exactly. You may need to look at the previous submittal to compare. But
mm-hmm. Okay.
There's a lot of difference. So I've added, this gable, this whole section is essentially new with the columns, the low railing is quite similar to the front house.
Previously, I think you had a roof that came wrapped railing only around the front.
Right,
yeah.
That didn't go all the way across.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Number four, consider removing the tacked-on roof on the south elevation.
Right.
Number five, although some members felt that a horizontal shiplap siding would be more appropriate, others found a vertical siding supportable.
It seemed like the consensus leaned more towards the horizontal siding.
So, and that matches the house in the front?
Correct.
And is this wood or hardy board material?
It's hardy.
Okay.
Number six, design the carports in a craftsman style.
Is that site built or prefab?
Pardon me?
Is it site built or prefab?
Site built.
Okay.
So these are steel columns that are going to be wrapped with lumber?
Correct. And what we're proposing at this point is concrete bases.
That are this high?
Yeah.
Okay. Durable. Number seven, review window placements, muttons, and sizes for the design and standardized proportions.
And again, you may want to look at the previous submittal, but I'm matching what's on the front house, which are primarily single hung and simpler. I had kind of a mixture of four light windows and some other things, but simplified it here.
And number eight, study the roof overhangs at the north elevation and perhaps resolve in a different manner.
Which we did. It's again quite different.
Anything else you want to add, color board?
These are the colors we're proposing. This is a sample that's similar to the front house now. This is what we're proposing as the body color on the new structures.
Window trim and front door.
Right.
And that window.
Yeah, window, the corner trim. Downspouts, not sure, but white.
So what's red versus, it says window trim and front doors, and I'm trying to find red on here. Well, so the actual...
I think on the... I don't think there is any. So we're not matching the front
okay.
with that.
So just to be clear, in this scenario, which is red and which is white and which is the tan color?
Sorry. So the thin in here would be the white. The window itself, this is the reddish.
Okay.
Okay, and then this is the tan, the body. White, fascia, corbels, columns. The rail is white.
Okay. Do you want to introduce your client, I assume?
The owner, John Barrett.
Hi.
Good.
Hi. Sorry for being late.
We're moving very fast today.
Yes, opposite of I needed them to be switched with last time. This time.
Anything else for your presentation?
I don't believe so. I think we covered it.
Oh, great. I will open up public comments. Is there anyone from the public wishing to address the board on this project? Seeing none, I'll ask staff if there are any public comments or any comments from you.
Just if you do approve it today, it'll be approved with the CEQA 15183 exemption, so I can give this to you so you can read it into the record.
Okay.
Thanks.
Good. So I will return it back to the board for questions of the board members to the applicant. Anybody in any particular order? Oh, yes. Quick question. The carport design, was there a trellis on one side? And would that trellis be only on this side, or was it on both sides?
Jane, can you
The idea was that it was on the side, because that's the part you see when you come out of in the drive and the existing home.
So it'd be a long...
So it'd be a nice buffer for them, visual.
They have a back porch here.
Okay.
Basically, we'd be looking at SARS. And give it some, you had said that you were looking for something that give it a little, make it not look like a 1950s carport. So it's just a trellis that had a little bit of a craftsman.
Yeah, no, I...
Detail.
Give me that sheet. Oops. There it is.
There it is.
Okay.
Just identify yourself for the record.
I'm Jane Barrett.
Thank you.
That's the question I have. Any other questions from anybody else?
Can we take another look at the landscape plan?
Yes.
What? Planting?
Yeah, please. Thank you. So are there new trees? Refresh my memory.
Yeah, I'll go over the trees real quick. We're going to cut out a tree planter in the existing sidewalk here, and the street tree is Brazilian cedarwood. We're doing three citrus trees in here and a new fruit tree here. We've got existing avocados dominating this area and over here, and we've got a screen of bamboo along this area because this neighbor really looks down on this area of the property. So that's kind of the major plantings.
The bamboo's on your property or neighbor's?
Ours.
And it's existing?
No, it's proposed.
What kind of bamboo?
Alphonse Carr bamboo.
Do you know what that means?
It's a clumping bamboo, not invasive.
Yeah, both of them, there's two different varieties, and I believe they're both clumping. Is that right, Aaron?
What's the other one I have?
Bambusa multiplex golden goddess.
Oh, yeah, that's just between these two units. They're both clumping, yeah.
Okay. Is the root barrier recommended with the clumping?
I would recommend it for both varieties, but it's up to the applicant.
Okay. I have another question.
Mr. Chair, did we get a lighting plan?
Exterior lighting, how are you addressing that?
Well,
you can come back the next time if you haven't addressed it yet. Usually it's a spec sheet that's on the plans showing the fixture.
two here.
Which are recessed up, so you won't see them. This is the one that I need to, I think.
Okay, we'll just make that a note.
So there's only four exterior fixtures.
Maybe one Five. Over here.
Five.
Yeah.
And
two that are actually,
wall mounted.
Right.
The other is a recessed can.
Correct.
Good. That's in the back.
Yeah.
I have a question. How are you doing? What paving pattern is new as of asphalt or pavers? And how are you addressing the stormwater management?
Well, the stormwater management plan that we're up against is tier two. So we're proposing to direct all of our runoff to all the permeable areas.
Okay.
I think there was discussion about whether or not to make the paving permeable, and I'm not sure where that went. But I believe we have enough, even if the paving is solid, we have enough permeable area to take the runoff.
So right now, the impermeable paving is what proposed?
We still need to do calculations.
So that's still kind of semi-unresolved. Is it less than 3,000 square feet total area, or whatever it is for Tier 2, between all of the asphalt and the building structure itself footprint? Or you don't know yet?
I can't tell you the square footages.
All right, we'll just leave that open-ended. Anything else from anybody else? Questions, comments?
None to comment?
Comments, yeah.
Okay, happy to start. I'm impressed that you made the changes that we asked for so well. I think the overall composition is greatly improved, and I like the color board. I think this project is doing very well.
Thank you.
I concur with those comments.
I had one thing. I was thinking the window itself should be the red color and the trim around the window should be white. And you were implying that the actual banding around the window was going to be red.
Correct.
Does any other board member want to...
Is that because you want to use vinyl windows?
Well, I think it could be either way. I mean, even if we do use vinyl. Mm-hmm.
It's because I've seen it done that way, and I thought it was executed, and that came together really well.
Okay.
Liked it. It was.
Talking to the microphone.
Oh, hello. It was just that I think it was really effective. It was done on a similar Craftsman cottage.
And it was that much wide of the red around the white window frame.
Yeah, it was. I have a photo of it, but I don't have it with me. The red on the mullions, I don't know. I guess it's...
I think you've answered enough. I raised my concern. If no one else is really chiming in on it, then it's going to be fine the way it's presented.
Mr. Chair, I did assume that we had wood windows, so I would like to know what the window type is.
Window material. Milgard, which is kind of what their fiberglass version of the... vinyls.
Right. They're thermally improved aluminum.
So it's painted white?
It is.
I'm sorry. So I've got to clarify this. My mistake. We've gone around and around so many times. But so this is the window that we're going to use, and they are aluminum windows that are white.
It is aluminum cladded, right? Coated with
clad aluminum.
Yeah, clad aluminum. That's what I saw is clad aluminum.
Yeah. Okay. So there's a little more dimension to them.
And the color would be?
We're still hoping for the white.
Okay, and then the trim around the window would be the red.
That's what we're hoping for.
So, Eric, is the plan correct then? Or does something need to be lined out in red?
On the exterior schedule, I'll have to change the color of the window.
So if you get an approval today, we'll just ask you to change it in red so that when you submit for your building permit, the plans match.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mr. Chair, I think the project is ready for final approval. With a couple of things to come back to the consent.
We're at project design approval, and then we can return to consent.
Yeah, we probably should have.
Hold off for a second. You can be after.
Yeah. So I'll revise that. Project design approval, not a final approval, because I think we should have some details, for example, a typical eave and door and window details. So do we have all those?
We still can say final on consent with these following outside items.
Okay. So I would say it is ready for final approval then. Not just project design approval, but final approval with a couple of items to return on consent. One would be the two light fixtures in the back that need cut sheets. And there was some other item. What was the other item?
A root barrier for the bamboos.
Only okay. Along the fence. I saw that you had them elsewhere also.
And then the applicant needs to do the stormwater management.
Water management. As to the extent that it affects the paving, we would need to review that, but it could be done on consent.
And I would say because stormwater management hasn't been provided, we cannot give the project final. So this would be project right. design approval, returning to consent with the following comments.
Okay.
Does that sound reasonable?
Yeah, but I, for some reason, thought he was meeting the T2, the Tier 2 swim requirement on sheet A2.1.
Did you do counts?
Well, I did. I calculated the square footages.
But I asked that question, you guys didn't really have the answer.
Well, I couldn't remember the square footages I had come up with.
I have that it needed to meet the basic. It needed the basic best management practice, which is one or more BMP. And I think
they're doing a parking lot. They're providing new parking.
Okay, it's not. Then that's. I don't see that as part of the project description. So that's why I calculated it at a T2 basic. How many, Eric? Was that added later on or something?
What's that?
New paving. Are you just slurry sealing, or are you doing a brand new parking lot?
Well, there's going to be some additional paving from what's there
okay,
now.
Okay, so that didn't make it into the project description from February. So I was unaware of that. This was kind of one of those projects where it was the planner who was staffing ABR was a different person, and then I came on
right.
after this. So it very well may be a higher SWMP tier than I was aware of.
So does it kick it into a tier 3 based on the square footage of
500
paving?
Square feet or more
of additional paving?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Replaced or new?
Can we just make that. This project design approval and return to consent and have you iron out the stormwater management stuff at a later date off?
I would suggest project design approval today, continued indefinitely, just like you said, to consent for final. And he can then bring all the details that you were requesting earlier, mm-hmm. Kirk, Board
yes.
Member Gradin, in addition to having the SWMP best management practices on his plans.
Great.
Okay.
Tip, you had a comment.
Yeah, I'd like to add one comment. I'm not sure how the other board members feel about the, I think that the massing is fine. It's acceptable. I think it works. What concerns me a little bit is the size of all the windows. And when I look at the existing house, it seems like the scale of the windows is better with the massing.
Mm-hmm.
For example, look at the north elevation, the front. I think that window is really small compared to the massing you have. And all the windows are a little bit, just a little bit, they're exactly the same. It's almost like you're flopping the windows on everywhere, and they are. But it seemed like it might need a little bit study to make sure that it matched the main house a little better in terms of scale of the windows and things like that. Because the main house, the windows are quite large when you look at the massing. So I'm a little concerned about the north elevation. I'm concerned about the south elevation. And I think that both are bedrooms upstairs, and that might be a little nicer anyway to bring a little more light inside.
I'll I'll chime in the sense that I noticed some issues with the windows, but I wasn't going to go there because I thought it was going to be, it's good enough or appropriate. I know this is your stairwell, and this window seemed odd, and I would think this window would be better here to have a little bit more wall mass, but I'm fine-tuning it according to my eye. The comment that Tip was just making, that this could be a larger window because the wall space is so large, and then you have a nicer view. I think those are, it's a valid comment, but I don't think we should, you know, deny the project, but it was just more advising you as the designer. There's more opportunities to tweak the windows and based upon the interior shape and the walls.
You know, I feel that's kind of a little important because what it does, it makes the scale of the building a little smaller too, less massive in terms of so much walls and all the smaller windows. So,
does someone else want to comment?
I think we could include that as an advisory comment that from two board members, but I would not add it to the motion because I think it still works in and of itself. It's the proportions still are not awkward.
I concur. An advisory comment is appropriate.
So with that, can you make or just classify that as a motion for you, and then if you wouldn't mind seconding it?
Can I have a comment before you go to that point, or do?
All right.
Okay. All right. Question, comment. I was hoping to get final approval and be able to move forward on the project, and I can appreciate that the permeable situation with the driveway has to get resolved before you can give that. So is there any way that, since the other items are very manageable on a consent basis later, is there a way that it is read into the record that it is approval dependent on, I'm sorry, I don't know the language for that, the permeable, that the pavement ratio, if it's kicked up to what do you call it, T3? That it meets those requirements. If it's to, you know, can that not be agreed upon that it will be what is, you know?
I would say
the design is all okay with you.
I hear what you're saying. One of the technical things is we do need to have the stormwater management resolved prior to giving a project final. By us giving it project design approval, it gives you the authorization or the okay to start your construction drawings. You're just not ready to go into the building department, and you're not ready to go in the building department. So as he does his construction drawings, he needs to visit us one more time, cleaning up a couple of loose ends that's not going to derail the project, as well as resolve the stormwater management issue, because that could trip up a couple of things that causes some tinkering on the overall site plan. That's why it's an indefinite continuance, because it's not something that he can guarantee get done in 2 weeks. So we can't give it final because the drawings are not at that level, but I wouldn't worry about the project because basically the overall size, bulk, and scale of your proposed scheme is something the board is in support of, and whatever comments we're making are minor in nature.
Okay, and so this, how does this process of the scheduling go, just so that if it is something they can do their...
I'll let your applicant or your architect or designer explain that to you.
Sure.
So we don't make a motion?
Well, I was just going to say we could continue it for 1 week to the consent calendar if you think you can have the swamp issues resolved at that point.
I think it's, assuming we don't go to Tier 3, I can do it, certainly. So let's do it.
Okay.
Okay, so you're going to have, you wanted door and window details, or are those in
there?
No,
they're on the plan.
You wanted light fixtures, cut sheets, that's easy. So you don't need details for doors and windows. And just the swamp, is that all that you're waiting for?
We also need to see the landscape compliance statement.
It's on the irrigation plan.
It is?
Oh.
We need a root barrier for the bamboo along the property line. And that's, to my knowledge, that's it.
If you're all right and you're okay with a 1 week consent, so we can say preliminary approval, return into consent in 1 week with the following comments that Kurt just made. Is there someone who would like to second that motion?
I'll second it.
Okay. Is there any other discussion? Does the applicant understand?
I do.
He can explain the timeline to you. Before we call for a vote, is staff on board?
Yes.
Okay. I'll call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye.
All right.
Opposed? Motion carries. I'll announce a 10-day appeal period, which is just a technicality, and return it back to consent in 1 week. And if you can't make it, notify staff.
Okay.
And also, you need to fill out a substitution sheet for this, and the one that the staff keeps, change the color on the schedule with red pen.
Okay. Thank you, Dan.
Thank you.
Moving on to item 3, which is 1605 Cook Place. We are 5 minutes early, if that's a problem with the applicant. It's not. This is a new public hearing, so I'm going to read the project description briefly. The National Oceanic Atmospheric Administration is proposing to establish an atmospheric river observatory on airport property in the appealable jurisdiction of the coastal zone. Site preparation will include the removal of 2 non-native trees, 1 non-native brush, and 60 linear feet of chain link fencing, and 200 square foot planter area. The atmospheric river observatory would consist of something, a wind profiler mounted on a 24 square antenna frame. Project has grading, requires planning commission review for a coastal development permit. This is for comments only. I have your name for the record and your presentation.
My name is Clark King. I'm a meteorologist for NOAA in the Earth System Research Laboratory in Boulder, Colorado.
Welcome to Santa Barbara.
Thank you. Been here many times. We actually used to have a radar at the airport. So what we're doing is, I'm sure this is a little different than what you're used to, but we're putting in 4 of these in California in partnership with the California Department of Water Resources. They're designed to look at extreme precipitation events, but the data that comes from these systems can also be used for general weather forecasting. The National Weather Service uses the data. A place like this, you can use it for fog forecasting, you can use it for the sundowners, the winds, the extreme fire events that you have sometimes here. So it has many uses.
Okay, great. Let's go through the, explain to us where it's on the site, and then we'll go through some site photos. This is where on the airport, if you can point out a couple landmark buildings to us.
At the end of the runway, correct?
So at the airport, it's at the very end of Cook Place.
Actually, I'm going to have staff jump in and introduce himself. You can sit in this chair. We don't bite yet. And then, like, where's the elephant bar in relationship to this?
Okay, Andrew Bermond, airport planner. The nearest landmark would be just off the edge on this is where the air traffic control tower is. This is one of the parallel runways, and this is the other one. The elephant bar would be way off. Okay. The intersection of Aero Camino, that's a lighted intersection on Hollister, is just
at the fire station somewhere right there?
Fire station's also down this way. This is the maintenance yard, the airport maintenance yard. Okay. And Carneros Creek right here.
Is it near Signature Aviation?
No. Signature Aviation does have does lease some of this land, yes.
Oh, okay.
But their offices are over on the other side of the parallel runways.
Okay. So this is the section of it or plan?
That's the plan. I brought a picture, if that would help.
Yes.
This is a similar site that we have in Bodega Bay, California. See. Kind of see what the actual antenna. This is the actual radar antenna here. These are called RAS enclosures, which is actually a sound source.
Okay.
And then this is basically the where the equipment is stored.
Okay. So then our particular site location, it's outside the, it'd be in this zone?
Yeah, so the site is within this area in here.
Okay. And are these the bushes that are being removed?
Yes, the...
But this oak is not?
No, the oak is not. It's the 2 small trees. I think I indicated it here.
Remove tree.
This is a large oleander bush. This bush is already gone, but it's these two small trees, and then the bush.
Okay. Go through the rest. Anything else for your presentation?
No.
I'm sorry to pepper you with questions. What about colors? What are you going to be color painting this?
The color, all the colors of the buildings we have are similar to this.
And then the white is going to be what you're proposing, and this grid and all this stuff is white.
Yeah,
so it's just like the painting. Picture.
Mm-hmm. These are all powder coated for the marine environment.
Cool. Anything else for your presentation?
No, sir.
All right, I will open up public comment. Is there anyone from the public wishing to address the board on this project? Seeing none, I will close public comment, return to staff. Do you have anything to add?
No, I don't. Thank you.
It's back to the board for questions of the applicant, and I have one last one. FHA or FAA has to review and approve projects that are built on the airport. Have they basically preliminarily reviewed this and given the thumbs up okay with
it? Yes, I submitted a 74 form, 7460. They approved both the heights and location and frequency of the radar. But then we moved this site slightly. So I resubmitted another FAA application in, which I'm expecting approval soon, because it actually was moved further away from any existing taxiways.
Okay, great. Okay, questions from the board members?
A quick question. Is there an existing fence that's going to remain, or is there a new fence going around this?
There's an existing fence that will remain. The only fence that's going to be removed is it pretty much goes down the center of the project.
Okay.
So it used to be a viewing area where the Forest Service would load their tanker planes. So it was an area where the public can come in and just watch the planes being loaded.
So what happens when we start having tanker planes being refilled here at the airport?
They moved to Santa Maria, I believe, so it probably won't happen.
Well, that would be a future project.
Is this a hangar?
It is, yes.
It's one of the older big ones?
Yes, that's a World War II era hangar.
Another question. How far are we from Hollister out here?
Well, diagrammatically, if this is that road, and where was the elephant bar, and where would the scale-wise?
It may be a challenge at this scale, this little point is the proposed project site, and then this yellow line is Hollister. Elephant bar would be over here on this side.
Yeah, but if we went with the scale of this element, mm-hmm. You said this is where the air traffic controller, could you say where the pen is Hollister, or where the pen is Hollister?
I would say it's probably over 1,000 feet from Hollister. What is the scale there?
That's 600 feet.
Yeah, maybe so.
Okay.
If I can keep my pen still.
And on this site plan, the orange element is this green here, right? So this is the white.
This is the white radar antenna here.
And then the orange tall box is that.
Is this here, yes.
Okay.
Could you paint the white any other color? Or is it already pre-made sitting in a box?
It's pre-made sitting in Boulder, Colorado, set up, ready to go. So. All of our units were made the same way.
Questions from anybody else? Hmm? All right, let's go to comments.
I think it's looks interesting.
And
I think it's fine. It's just I really don't think we should impose any color to that white thing.
All right. Anybody else?
As far as industrial installations, it's pretty innocuous.
So would someone like to make a motion giving this project design approval with returning it to consent after, sending it on to Planning Commission and then after Planning Commission, returning it back to consent.
That's fine, but it won't get project design approval. You're just giving it comments.
I'm sorry.
That's all right.
Project only, return as forwarding it on to Tip. I'm looking at you.
Yeah, the project I submitted as is acceptable to the board, and the board has no comment.
Return to consent for project design approval and final after Planning Commission.
Second.
All right, anything else? If not, I'll call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. We need to save one of these.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
I can take this.
Yes.
No. Yep. Okay.
We're on to item four. Is that applicant here? We are 25 minutes early. Would you like to be heard early, or do you want to wait?
Most you can take is 15 minutes early, so you need to take a... What time is the next item?
4:30. So we're going to take a 10-minute recess, and if possible, we could start item four at that time, because...
15 minutes ahead.
15 minutes ahead, which is 128 Anacapa Street. Items to item two briefly, which is 122 South Valeria Street. Do you have a seat in the front row?
South Valeria. Not Valeria.
Ontario. I'm not on it. You can push this button yet. Sorry about that, sir. Reopening ABR for today, which is Tuesday, May 27th. We're going to go back to item two, which is 122 South Valeria Street. We're going to reopen the motion we made because we did not read the CEQA comment. The motion was made by Kirk. Would you mind adding that?
Yes. So we'll add the comment. The Architectural Board of Review finds that the project qualifies for an exemption from further environmental review under CEQA guidelines section 15183 based on the city staff analysis and CEQA certificate of determination on file for this project.
And that was seconded by Scott. Is that okay with you?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Thank you.
Okay. No need to call for a new vote?
No.
All right. Now we
need to vote on it.
Let's call for a new vote. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Now we're on to item four, which is 128 Anacapa Street. This is for final review. We're starting this item 15 minutes early. We have the minutes from the previous meeting. Pass it on to you. Have a seat, introduce yourself, and then would you like us to read the minutes, or do you have a presentation in mind?
Joe wasn't here at the last meeting.
Okay. So introduce yourself to begin with.
Jim McDonald, owner.
Joe Ewing, architect.
Okay.
And Dawn Sherry, who is consultant, and she was going to be here, but she's on the dark continent. She's in Africa. So, but we figured that with the comments that the board made, that her office drew up all the details that was required. So I thought that we'd be able to proceed.
Okay. So what we'll do is we'll have Kirk read the minutes of the previous meeting, and then you tell us what page to find these things. Some of us will jot down notes, and then you can add anything to the presentation, and then we'll move on.
Okay. The project was given project design approval last month on the 28th. And continued indefinitely to the full board with the following comments. Number one, the board appreciated the height reduction. Number two, the board provide adequately recessed windows at the south property line, and where windows are at the property line, provide window details.
So where do we find that?
Page, I think it's 12 and 13.
There's 12, so recessed window detail.
Probably 13 and 14, then. I think it's on the next page over. Recessed window.
Typical recessed window scale.
Okay.
There. 2x6 studs.
Yeah. These are 2x6?
Yeah.
Okay. And then let's look at the elevation. Was it the south elevation that they asked for?
Yes.
elevation were they referring to?
It's there somewhere.
Next one.
A5, A6.
That's here we are, right?
That's the north elevation.
Let's go two more sheets.
Yeah. South of the front.
Here we go. Here we are, right here.
Oh, yeah. This is the southeast elevation.
These guys here, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is where we asked for recessed windows?
And these would need to be as well, right?
The whole project will have recessed windows. As this wall, it's all going to be 2x6 wall, except for this wall, it's 2x8. So they'll really be recessed all the way into the. They'll be flush on the inside.
Just to make it clear, typically you would key in a detail to the windows so that the. Inspector, that's when he's reviewing the
these,
so what
there was a this is Joe did key. I don't think I have that. He did key in all the sheets.
You have A6 there.
A6. No.
Well, let's just make this a comment for us, and we'll just keep moving forward.
Those are the.
But if these are the windows, the comment, and you understand that.
Just to get all the keys.
And do we need to see the front elevation, or is just
Let's see it. I think that was part of the concern.
Okay. And then
Well, I think all of them. We just wanted to make sure that, because it looked like on the plan that you had thicker walls along this three elevation, but there was no detail showing the recess of the windows, so... We were wanting to see that. And again, it's not properly keyed in, so we can't really refer to the detail. I'll just go on.
Okay.
Number three, the railing over the driveway entrance should be returned to the pilasters, and the pilasters should be set back from the face of the balcony a minimum of 12 inches.
Let's go to second floor plan. Is that this?
It was, yeah, it's right here.
So the second floor plan. Here's the...
No, what we did was move the post on the top so it's one line all the way up rather than being back. Dawn thought it would look better.
This?
It doesn't look like it's been moved back. It looks it's the same.
Do you understand what the comment was to put the railing kind of in the middle midpoint between these two columns instead of at the face?
There is it's the front here.
Yeah, it's the front.
And it is in the center of this wall here, 2x6 wall. I think it was unclear last time the way it was drawn, and I think Howard. It was unclear, so what we did was, if you could A5 and then A6 shows it.
There's A5.
So it's just a straight pilaster with a plain decorative band around it.
A6.
So it just follows straight up. This wall is on one plane.
But it's not represented that way in plan.
Yeah,
it's still set back in plan.
We had drawn that too.
Okay, let's move on.
Okay. Number four, provide adequate screening for the backflow preventers.
That's on the landscape?
And here's David Black. He was just.
We started early. We can move on.
Okay. Number five, provide a corrected paving plan. Show material and enhanced paving at the street frontage with colored concrete at a minimum.
All right. Actually, are there a lot of landscape stuff?
No, I don't remember that being a comment.
Can I get a copy of that, and we'll just do those two landscape items right now? And Joe, would you mind if... So there were two, what was the first one?
The backflow preventer.
Well,
introduce yourself first.
David Black, landscape architect.
Okay.
So it was pointed out that perhaps there wasn't enough shrub material at this location where the backflow is shown in the irrigation plan, so we've added some of that. And then the only other comments were sort of the disposition of the paving here. So what we're showing here is flagstone, as it's shown here, out to the sidewalk, and then, and it's called out, is it, right here, and then a interlocking permeable paver, which is also called out here. Sort of delineate those in that motor court area. Mm. Those were the, sort of the primary issues, as I remember them.
Yeah, that corresponds with the comments.
Okay.
And if the board would like, I brought the pictures to this is an old job that we did in Summerlin. And we did the same, used the same thing, and here's a sample of what the walk would look like.
Great.
And if you wanted a sample, I mean, here's a sample of a flagstone, the Arizona buff, and then this is the tumbled paver.
All right.
Number six was provide all architectural details of the exterior portions of the building.
So that would be back like the last. I think it was the last three pages. These are all exterior. Okay. So there's these.
Gutters are, what's the material of the gutters?
Copper.
Is that indicated?
Yeah, it's on the color boards.
Okay.
Where does that internal gutter occur on the roof plan?
That's at the property line.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
You have a typical eave condition? Oh, what's this? With mortared stop?
Yeah.
Grout eave closure. The material of the gutters and downspouts should be noted on the plan as well, not just on the color board.
Okay. This page. Oops.
Understanding this, I guess, because it looks like the window or door is coming out to the face of the plaster as opposed to the plaster returning and having the window or door recessed.
Looks like there's two details, one for recessed and one for non-recessed.
Yeah.
So again, keying in on all of the elevations, what details are occurring where would be, or it's necessary.
Like here, there's a sheet
balcony.
Metal cap.
Yeah.
I'm not sure where this occurs, but
there's a way to detail this so you don't have the sheet metal exposed on the front end of the... Oh, this is probably the front, the exposed side.
Yeah, it slopes back to the inside of the terrace.
Sometimes we wrap this whole thing with bitumen over the top 6 inches on each side and slope the top one way or the other so that you don't have a sheet metal flashing. And you can take a look at Ruth Chris Steakhouse and see what they look like after about 5 years. The way we don't want it to look.
I'd also like to see an alternative at the Weeps Greed. So you can still, by code, you do have to have the screed terminate 2 inches above the hardscape, but you can finish the foundation wall below that point.
Go ahead and finish it.
Yeah, so we need, it can be with plaster or other material, but it needs to be finished, can't be.
Go to the next sheet. Move on. Oh, anything else?
I would say at the bay window too that to have a return. I don't know. No, I guess it depends on what that. So the problem for me with this detail and occurs on other details is that there's just a dashed in line showing where the window occurs. It doesn't show what that window looks like, the profile of the window. And so it's hard to say, you know, where's the glass? Is the glass back here? Is there a recess to it?
I think that's a general comment that can be made about all these details, that it's a very uniform detail that can be for anything. But once you know what your window spec is, you can throw that in there. Then we know it has a slope sill, and how does this all relate? So this is like 80% there, but the details are not refined to reflect the end.
I mean, we're using Eagle windows.
And so then it's really easy to insert some type of window profile here so you can finish the rest of it off, because right now it's still kind of open-ended. It just appears that way, and that's a comment.
Yeah.
You'll need to understand, or it's understandable. Okay, let's move on.
Well, I think that was the last.
Oh, that was?
Oh, provide all exterior lighting fixture details, which we just have one there. I saw that.
Okay. And it won't have a 60-watt bulb. It'll have the fluorescent.
Right.
You'll have to have that.
That's and no glass on top.
Yeah, that's perfect because then that gives you the dark sky.
And the color is black? Or?
Yeah.
Do you have the color board, please? Yes.
Anything else you want to add for your presentation? And as you received project design approval and it's here for final?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Anything else for you?
It got PDA already.
Right.
I'm sorry. I thought you said it was here for
PDA. I'm just clarifying it.
He's here for final.
So with that, if there's no other comment, I'll open up public comment. Does that sound reasonable?
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Open up public comment on this item. Is there anybody wishing to speak? Seeing none, I'll close public comment, return to staff. Are there anything else? Okay. So now it's to the board for questions of the applicant. And this is for final review, which is going to be for submittal into the building department. Or at least, complete architectural design.
I don't have any questions. I have comments.
Okay. Any other questions? Moving on to comments. You want to go first?
Sure. Well, I think what was represented and described in terms of the changes you made sound good. It's just some more clarification in terms of what's shown on the plan so that we can verify that the details that are being called out are actually where those occur on the elevations. So that's one comment. And I still see that there's maybe further clarification needed on where you have unique details. For example, I don't know now, looking back, whether this particular shelf is detailed on the plan. This looks like it's got a plaster molding that's different than the way the other doors and windows are shown. This window looks different than that window. And this is where, I believe this is wood bay window occurs. But so when you come back, if you can key in where those unique details occur on the elevations and where they occur on the plan so that we can verify all that. And then the comment made last time about this and the resolution you came to for these front columns appears to be acceptable. It just looks like it wasn't represented properly in plan, on the floor plan. And then the comment on the details. Number one is include a typical window and door profile wherever those occur in the details. And just to clarify that we are looking for as deep a recess as can be had given the wall thicknesses for all the exterior walls. And that also it's another comment that where parapets occur that there should be no visible flashing. And where at eave terminations where you do have flashing showing at the fascia that the dimension of that flashing should be minimized as much as possible. Another comment that the to show the copper gutters and downspouts as being such on both the details and the elevations, it should be called out. And again, because the details aren't keyed in to the elevations, it's hard to tell whether you do have a complete set here. It may be complete, but it's not possible really to evaluate it at this stage. So when it comes back, we can then identify and make sure that you've covered all the critical areas. And that would be continued. The consent calendar could come back next week if you like. That would be mine. I guess that's a motion, actually, or comments, because there may be other comments.
Well, it's a good start framework for a motion if someone wants to second it or at least flag it in the computer. I had one question for the board members as well as for the applicant having to do with the garage door. What header height do you have here and what this material is and what the difference is between the two and whether or not there's a possibility of putting an 8-foot door or a 9-foot door and making this all open wooden frame all the way to the top so that your header is actually above?
This is way back.
Back.
That's the back it's unit. Like
30 feet back.
Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I was reading it. Okay, never mind. Good. That was my only comment. So we have pretty extensive comments that can be rolled into a motion. Does somebody want to second that?
Second.
Who made the motion? What was the
motion? He hadn't made a motion yet. It was comments.
There were
well,
comments.
Well, it was all my comments.
Okay.
You may have to remake it.
Okay.
And who seconded, Scott?
Tip.
But I heard Kathy tapping on the keyboard. So if she can reread what she has, just for the, for us.
Clarify the unique door and window details and location and their location.
Yeah.
Okay, do you understand what that comment is? Clarify the unique details.
I have
and their location on the elevations.
And their location on the elevations.
Yep, got that.
Clarify the unique door and window details and the locations on the elevations. Include a typical door and window profile where the door and window details appear on the plans. Provide exterior, is it thickness details or wall details?
I'm not sure what that.
It was the deeper recess on the exterior walls.
Oh, just that we are looking for, just to clarify, that we're looking for as deep a recess as possible at all the exterior walls.
And there shall be no visible flashings at the eave terminations at the fascias. Where there is flashings, minimize as much as possible.
Actually, if I may correct, there should be no visible flashings at the parapet. Parapets, it's plural.
Which
there's different
like this right
types.
Top of the
wall.
You meant parapets and railings, correct?
No, call out the elevation details on the plans for identification.
I think you could also just add a general comment that the just key details to elevations and elevations shall match the floor plans.
Exactly, that would do it.
Because I think you said some of the there were some windows that weren't showing up or something on the floor plan.
See how this window glazing is inches from the front face, but in plan we're actually you're indicating that it's further back. Mm-hmm. So these need to be redrawn so that when the building inspector goes, he actually knows what our intention is. And the same thing with the little hiccup that's happening here in the front. Kathy, a comment that was made. Or if it's okay if we add to note the gutter material on the details.
And elevations.
And elevations. And this is just a suggestion that the applicant look for a weep screed detail that minimizes the amount of exposed concrete footing. And did you cover this railing thing in your comments? Is that what she said?
Yes.
So we have a motion, we have a second. Is there any other?
What is the motion? Was it approved or continued?
No, we have a motion by Kurt. We have it seconded by Tip. Mm-hmm. This is kind of abnormal what we're doing
I
today.
I heard all the comments, but what's the actual motion?
Oh.
Do you need 1 week to consent?
Yes.
1 week to consent.
Yeah. This may be outside our purview, but I noticed that none of the windows are dimensioned location-wise in planner elevation. You could save yourself a lot of contractor callbacks by just getting some more dimensions on your plans.
That's just no one window schedule. That's probably why.
Well, they're not located anywhere horizontally. There's no.
That's an advisory.
Yeah, that doesn't need to be included.
He's the builder. Sure. Good luck.
Oh, okay. There you
and
go.
And that's why.
The builder set.
It
gotcha.
Is because.
Yeah. But it just when it's finally built, we know that you haven't moved windows around because they're
right,
nailed
down.
Right,
right.
Yeah. Move them back.
I would say that should be a typical requirement for every plan that we give final approval to, that the doors and windows are properly dimensioned.
Here's an example.
In their location from wall corners. Because, for example, as you just mentioned, what is that dimension? Where is that actually
right,
sitting?
Right.
You're going to need to know that to build it, so why not have it on the plan now? And then we know where it's going. So I think we can add that.
Is that okay with the seconder to add dimensions to the windows and openings? Okay. Any other discussion or any other comments to the motion that's on the floor? If not, I'll call for a vote, and this is for
final.
No, this is just a 1 week continuance to consent.
Okay, and now just one question. It has to go to consent first before we go into the building. Well, these have to be done anyway before you go into the building department.
Yeah, because
so
there's
that's
a couple
just,
of hiccups here that just need to clean it up, and if you get it done in a week, great, and if you need 2 weeks, just tell staff, and you'll go on to consent, and it's either going to be Kurt or Scott that'll review it. Or, I'm sorry, Stephanie.
Okay.
One of these three will review it.
We can, you can do it in a week, right?
Oh, yeah. I've been out of town back and forth, burying too much.
All right. With that, I'll call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. It's a one-week continuance. And staff will save one of these for the record. And can the landscape architect provide the updated sheet?
It's there.
It's there.
That's what I put before you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Make sure staff has it in the file.
Is it this?
Thank you.
Set? I think it's this set.
Sorry, I'll get you.
Thank you for your patience.
Sure.
When you see it, you're going to love it.
That'll be great.
All right, we're starting this next one 15 minutes early. This is 101 North Milka Street. This is a new item, so I will briefly read the project description. This is a proposal for renovation and exterior alterations to an existing 2,660 square foot commercial building comprising of the following: demolishing the existing planter, front steps, dumpster enclosure, and construct new ADA accessible entrance and ramp. Add new exterior ATM, replace trash enclosure, hardscape, and landscape. Also proposed is to restripe the parking lot, replace parking lot lighting, replace doors and windows, install a fire department connection and backflow device, and repaint the exterior of the building. We have your name for the record, and then you can tell us briefly where we are in town.
Sure.
And your presentation.
Sure. My name is Rob Jacknowitz. I'm the applicant. With me today here is Paul Kilsmeyer with Wells Fargo Bank. What we are proposing, this is what was...
Shazam.
Sorry about that. This was formerly the Blockbuster Video site at Milpas and Mason. There's a McDonald's right across the street. Blockbuster moved out in February. So I don't know if... and they were pretty good about removing any and all evidence that they were there. So, needless to say, this was originally a Mission Federal Savings and Loan built in 1978. The bank added ATMs out here in 1983, which is ironic because we're bringing this back in 2014 as a bank and putting ATMs back out front. As far as all the improvements we're doing here, starting out front here, we are bringing in fire service to sprinkle this building. So in this island out here is where the equipment, the backflow preventer, and then you'll see there's a landscape plan that hides all that equipment as well. The parking lot is existing. There are 18 spaces. Due to accessibility standards and the dumpster enclosure here, that'll go down to 17 spaces. 11 are required. We're replacing the very, very large parking lot lights with much smaller ones. It's well lit, as you can probably see at night, so it doesn't need to be. Our light poles will only be 12 feet tall, so we're concentrating our light to where we need it exactly. As far as landscaping, this had a nice landscape plan when you guys originally approved it, and over the years it's all died and has not been replaced, so there's very little left. Sure.
So we are adding quite a bit.
Landscape plan is probably the last sheet here. Yes. Once again, Blockbuster did have, in the bank before Blockbuster had a monument sign out here. We're putting one back here. And we're redoing what... really, there's very little that exists out here today and throughout the rest of the site. Most of this is either overgrown or dead and missing. So we are replacing all the landscaping here.
Okay.
We are making some other site improvements. There was originally a dumpster enclosure back here. At some point, the structure was removed. The pad is still there. It's under about 6 inches of pine needles, but it's still there. We are having to construct a new dumpster enclosure, which will contain, refuse dumpster as well as a recycled dumpster. You'll notice that it does need now to be handicap accessible. This will be our handicap accessible parking place as well. Entrance into the bank, we're making accessible. Entrance up here, the ramp here to the ATMs and night depository will be accessible as well.
Okay. What are the exterior elevations and what color scheme?
Here's the color scheme there. We have full size, but of course they're black and white, and there are the colors.
So this yellow here, this goldenrod?
Yes.
Is that this one? Or you don't have that one shown?
Is that this one?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's actually a surface that interfaces with our ATM surrounds. So that's a color in itself. It's actually an acrylic panel.
Okay. And that's the only exterior change? Are you replacing all the doors and windows?
Canopy.
Paul, are we replacing these over here?
Yes, I'm putting all in glass, dual glaze, so that I get energy efficient. We're actually going to do a LEED certified building as well. So replacing the HVAC as well as all the windows.
So the new metal storefront?
Yes.
Okay, and then on here, do you have the colors or something like that noted?
The
this be black?
I believe it's all supposed to be black.
Yeah, it would be. Yeah. Right.
Thanks.
Replace doors and windows. Okay. Anything else for your presentation?
No, this should really try to make this a lot nicer. It's a nice building. The tile roof is to remain. And this does have a flat roof in the center, and that's where all the mechanical equipment is located.
So recess down.
Some of the other notes, we are trying to make this site, as you know, this is a completely developed site, which is challenging. We are trying to make some improvements here. Some of the downspouts are being diverted then into the landscape beds to help with some of the runoff from the tile roof sections.
Great.
Which was a recommendation that staff had asked us. Try to make improvements where you can.
Alrighty. So I think that was a good presentation. Let me open up public comment.
Chair, we haven't looked at the elevations yet, the drawn ones, or any details.
That's
site demolition.
Oh.
Here's our interior floor plan. In this case, we're not changing the openings of the windows. We're changing out the actual windows.
We also haven't seen the photos of what's there.
Oh, there.
All right, there.
Color ones.
We have color photos, Susan.
Oh. Is it this? They're here.
These are color?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I have them in my hand.
Yeah.
They went to another member.
So existing roofing is staying?
Yes, it is.
Context.
So it's a nice site. Just needs a little tender loving care. It's
not, once again.
Yeah.
Can we take a look? Yeah.
Anything else for you?
Paul, do you have anything to add?
Just clarification.
Hold those questions,
okay.
And you'll be first.
All right.
I'm going to open up public comment. Is there anyone from the public wishing to address the board on this item? Seeing no one come up, I'll close public comment and return it back to the board for questions.
Okay. So I see the ramps requiring a wall. It looks like you're putting a stone veneer on it.
Yes.
And that's imitation stone veneer. It's cement. The metal canopy. Where's the metal canopy?
Under the ATM.
Oh, this is it here.
This is from the sign package, but this would clearly.
You have like a section cut through there showing that?
That's it. That's it. This is from the same package. Like I said, this all comes from the
with the ATM.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's why.
So it's a 2-foot extension over the ATM, but here it looks bigger. Is that different?
Yeah.
That's the natural overhang of the building itself.
Yeah, we're not creating or adding on anything.
Yeah, that's for the ATM.
It doesn't look like on the pictures. Don't see it anywhere. Is that the right elevation? Maybe not.
Yeah, that seems to be the new added-on metal canopy.
That's called out as such, new metal canopy.
He got that new metal canopy. Yeah, you're right. It is not dimensioned correctly. That's the way it comes out.
But the 9'4" versus how it's basically almost flush with this roof overhang. See how this is the distance between here and here?
Yep.
And
it seems very high.
So this whole bay, basically, that's popping out is going to be that plexiglass or
this acrylic panel.
Acrylic.
Yeah.
I don't believe this has been approved at other Wells Fargo banks. And that's why I'm bringing up the sample for you guys to look at that yellow color.
Got one.
Is this different than that?
No, it's the same one. It just, one of them came out bigger than the other one.
Okay. Do you have a detail of this wall, of how that's constructed? What kind of cap is on it, or?
I don't know if he's got anything on the landscape plan for that. Or did he put that on the site plan? Sorry, I'm not. You know what? I'm going to put mine just so I can see it quicker.
Detail 20 on A2.1.
If you flipped it.
Which page?
Next one. Right here. There you go.
There's the side wall. And it shows the veneer. It's a C elevations. Footing is 100% on the property.
There is an existing wall. You can see it in your photos that's out there. We're trying to mimic back what that is. It's just in bad shape. Like I said, everything was neglected.
And the trash enclosure wall will be finished with plaster or?
I'll do a little bit of these. Yeah, plaster, skip coat. Painted to match the building.
And the gates are those detailed as well?
Gates. Let's see if I can door panel made steel decking with 2x2 steel water frame.
Number 13.
again, trying to go back to what was there. So,
this is actually a vertical steel decking?
Yeah. Okay. I see that.
Well, you finish up your comments, and okay. then we'll go down.
Well, yeah. Questions. So the storefront's being replaced, and just to clarify the color, is it one of these? Color of the storefront? Or is it?
I think we're just going to go back with the dark anodized, you know, the what's there now.
Which is like this or like this?
Maybe it'd be the darker, the black.
Okay, so this says trim cap. Is there a cap somewhere also?
We use that. This will follow through with the signage as well. That's why we call it trim cap. It goes around the edge of the monument sign. What do I do with my sign plan?
I tried to.
Oh. Like, for instance.
I have a scale.
Yeah, the color board came with our signage package.
I think so.
To kind of
both.
Somewhere. It was on the monument.
If it's not on the architectural plan, oh, yeah.
This question at hand is what's the color of the mullions for the door and windows?
Yeah, and then is there, well, he already said it's going to be this black, but then the other question was, is there a cap somewhere? I just, on the building?
No.
Okay, all right.
No. Yeah, the building itself, you know, the roof cap, all of that, the roofing materials all stay the same.
Okay.
Do you have anything else?
I think the only other question is lighting on the building exterior. Are you replacing fixtures on the building itself?
You want to go over the lighting, because that was one of my concerns, and I had a couple questions. We had the photometrics here, and then you have cut sheets of what's being proposed. This is what was given to me.
Yeah.
And then I noticed this says a shoebox light. So is it this fixture just mounted here, and then these are pole mounted?
Yes, those are 12-foot poles.
Okay, this is 12, this is 8, and then your detail had 20, so there was a little inconsistency.
Looks like you're adding one here, too.
That.
And these?
Yeah, and these. The reason for this is this 60-foot radius for AB 244.
Correct, we understand.
Yeah, that's what these are for.
But this is a surface-applied light to the architecture?
Yes.
Can we go to the elevations to see how these are interfacing with the architecture?
I hope.
Maybe we just don't want a little cobra head just sort of sticking. It's going to be this little wing wall that it's going to be sticking on, or how is it being integrated?
Paul, do you know right offhand how he's integrating that?
Okay. And then, if you don't mind if I'm going to follow up, can we dimension what the height is from like the finished floor to the underside of your canopy? Because the lighting thing says it's 8 feet, and then the sign package said it was 9'4", and I just wanted to scale your elevations to see where I'm seeing some inconsistency. Did I assume this is drawn to scale?
Yes.
And this is a quarter inch.
Well, knock on wood, it should be.
It says quarter inch. Okay.
So it's about the printer. Yeah, it depends on the printer.
It definitely depends on the printer, because this is scaling out at 7 feet, so I know this isn't right. And then this number right here, where did I see 9? That's to the top, so it's 8'4" to the underside.
Right.
Okay, so, okay.
The intent is to have a 2 feet depth, not the,
yes.
Is that right?
Foot depth, 8 feet from the finished floor.
Right.
And then the question really is, what's the distance between the finished floor to the underside of this roof overhang? Because you've got this great place for pigeons to roost. And that's just a question that we're just sort of coming up
sure.
with. Sure. Okay. Does anyone else have questions to run?
I have a question.
Okay, go for it.
It seemed like you're adding a new handicap ramp in front.
And, yes.
By doing so, you're creating a planter. right here?
Yes.
And so how much dirt you have left to plant something by the time you do 14-inch walls? And
very little.
So
very
it would be better to just do a solid wall instead of have, because it seems like you have like 10 inches
well
less for planting something.
We are trying, originally, see, exactly right out front here. There used to be, if you look at the site demo plan, there used to be a planter right here, and then there still is a portion of this planter here. This planter, that wall is still there, and then they just came in, removed the landscaping, and poured a concrete pad, and just covered all that up. So we're trying as best we can to add some.
But you had to put in a handicap ramp, which wipe out your planter.
I mean, I see what you're saying. Do you, is that like necessary in that tiny space?
We don't are have much left.
Well.
Yeah, and right now this is all concrete across here, so we were just trying to bring color and landscaping to the project. But
we are.
If it doesn't mean.
I think it helps that elevation tip and the width of the planter. You know, even if it's 6 inches, if you have full soil depth, you could plant a lot of different things in
one of the other things
quantity.
We have to consider is the fact we are removing 496 feet of impervious, square feet of impervious surface. We're putting back 489. So that does not give us much when we go over the 500 square foot threshold, which would trigger a. So we're trying to be very conscious of staying under that 500 square feet.
Okay.
I think you answered the question.
Any other questions?
One quick question.
Go for it.
What other options do you have for the yellow backdrop at the ATM? Is the yellow non-negotiable?
Our next option is to have an all-bronze panel, and that's what this color chip actually comes with the sign package, and we brought that to you so you would have this question. So we either go from the yellow, then we go into the bronze, or we go...
You have to try and get on the mic, that's what they're calling it.
No. So our first option is the yellow, and that's what's noted in the color elevations. And then if we go that, then we go into a bronze type of color. And then from there, we go back to our just standard traditional surrounds like we have at Anacapa, with nothing behind it, just the wall.
So it's plaster then?
It would be plaster or whatever wall material is there. Right now, there's actually tongue and groove, or there's some button board there.
So it's still there, the hole for the ATM.
This is a new concept for wells. We started this about a year and a half ago. We're rolling it out across the country. Some of it is illuminated, some of it is not. This was non-illuminated.
Great.
So those are the three options.
If there are no other questions, we can go to comments. Does someone have one to go first?
Go ahead, Tip.
Yeah, I feel that the proposal is acceptable. It's definitely clean up the building. Landscaping help. Just have a concern about the front wall, front landscaping strip. Either it works or doesn't work. It seems a little bit tight to do a little planter right in front. And I think the project is ready for, would you come in for what, for preliminary approval or what?
So action can be taken, so whatever the board feels.
Let's hold off on making that statement until we hear other people's comments, unless you strongly feel it's ready for preliminary or project design approval.
Probably we've had a few comments.
You want to go?
Sure. I think you've done everything very well. I think it's a vast improvement to what's there. My concern really centers around this area here. I think the canopy that you're proposing looks redundant because it's just below the roof, doesn't stick out any further. Seems like that could be eliminated. As Paul said, it's like a pigeon roost. And then I don't think I'm entirely on board with the yellow. I think the building is, it seems at odds. It's very slick and interesting, but it seems at odds with, the building is much of a different time, so to speak. And so I feel that the yellow is a little too dramatic. Everything else on the building, and I think that it might be, tuning it down might improve the building. My comments.
I'll concur with the yellow that it just needs some work one way or the other, and the redundancy of the overhang. If this is the little splay corner, which is representing this corner here, and if there's a light fixture here, it doesn't go with the architecture. It's not integrated well, and so there's a hiccup kind of here that needs to get addressed. So if you could show on the elevations kind of the exterior light fixtures. And then there's this pole light, and my first concern was the light spill on the adjacent neighbor. But then when you go to the photometrics, this fixture isn't shown. So there's an inconsistency between what I'm looking at here versus that other sheet. So,
well, that's an existing one. Oh, he does have his new.
Well,
sorry.
You probably didn't update the site plan. He submitted revised photometric today showing zero at the property line.
Yeah. Perfect, which is the reason why that goes through those hiccups. So
absolutely.
Then that's the one thing. And then the handrail was pretty utilitarian and could have a little bit more character one way or the other. I mean, if it's just regular metal that's galvanized, it looks a little on the bland side. And just if there was a way that you can find some motif.
It's shown painted to match the building.
Oh, it's galvanized. It's just the standard kind of stuff you'd find in any elementary school on campus.
So you're talking about the style. The
style and character of the handrail could use improvement just to have a little more kick to it instead of just being utilitarian, minimalist, you know. And I'm throwing that out as a comment. Do you understand?
Okay. Oh, no, I understand. I'm just trying to, I mean,
I'm not asking for lamb's tongue and all that, but something that has a little character. That was my one. And these are my
Hispanic
comments.
Hispanic to go with the building, I think, is the idea.
Well, and then the metal on the decking here, I'm not quite sold. Maybe I need to see an elevation of it, but it seems a little too, if you're going to be going contemporary style, it'd be nicer if that was just solid wood that was painted, you know, tongue and groove board, wood boards, or some type of look. But right now, this is just, once again, it's the cheapest gate you can build. And this is the cheapest handrail you can build, even though you galvanized it. Looking for something with a little bit more character. Those are my comments.
I concur with those comments, and I would also add that the lighting fixtures on the that face the public, so this one and these two, just to simply match the head at the pole fixtures is. Does not seem to me to be appropriate. You could, I think there's other ways of lighting that area, either with a fixture, a wall-mounted fixture that's more in keeping with the style of the architecture, or down lights in the overhang. Mm-hmm. I think there's other ways of doing it rather than the selection you've made in those areas. And for me, the color is not so much an issue with the yellow, but the material is. And I would like to see just plaster there as part of the surround as opposed to metal. Those are my comments.
Courtney?
I agree with Scott's comment related to the yellow color on the ATM. I think that's a little harsh. Agree with Paul's comment regarding the handrail at the front of the building. And I think, you know, as much planter space as you can get is preferable, especially on the front elevation of the building facing Milpas Street. Regarding the landscape plan, the Mason Street elevation has quite a big, large sort of blank wall. So if you could just have the landscape architect address that with the planting. It's not at that level yet, the plan.
Okay.
None of the plants are called out yet because it's a preliminary plan, which is fine. For this level, but just in the next time you come, just make sure they call out what everything is.
Okay.
And then regarding the trees, there's two Lagerstromia shown on the south side of the parking lot. I would consider using more of a shade tree in that location so that we can provide shading on the parking lot. That's it.
Jeff, can I add one more comment?
Yeah.
About the color, about the yellow color, I think I do agree with Kurt about the yellow. Personally, I really don't think the yellow would be an issue because it's
I think the Wells Fargo is yellow, right? The golden bronze. And the building is black brown, and I think the yellow is really complementary with the brown and the roofing. And I think that's one way of trying to wake this building up a little bit. And Milpas is really a really heavily Spanish neighborhood, which I think a little color make it more exciting, so painted something else. And especially, you know, the ATM machine had to be a little more visible for safety and all the kind of things. So because of that, I really, I hope we can push for the yellow, because that's a great, and I'm just not sure about the plaster or not, because it's right next to the ATM. Unless you do a really perfect plaster job, you might have, you know, a metal might be a better finish for it next to the ATM machine. It's really a machinery equipment that, and I think the yellow really helped the elevation. That's just my opinion.
Can I clarify something? Can you
clarify? This is actually the color, but if you actually look at the sign plan, you can see the waves and bands. There's actually a what we call rains and roads that actually has a in the acrylic. So it's not just a flat yellow. There is a
pattern.
There is a movement and a pattern that is definitely reflected in that acrylic.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's really nicely complement the brown.
In some respects, we can take...
Mr. Chair, excuse me. So you're saying the samples on the sample board are not really what the finish will look like on the building? Because if that's the case, we need actual samples show. If there's some kind of... texture
did.
Or there's movement on what the final product will be, the ABR needs to see that.
This came from Tony.
At this point,
yes, it did.
At this point, I kind of think we should give you a strong direction. Either there's a majority of the board that can support the yellow, or the majority of the board would like you to go away from the yellow.
I was going to suggest choice. A straw vote, yeah.
So I'd like to call for a straw vote on giving the applicant that the yellow is workable, or we'd rather see you not work with the yellow.
Are we talking yellow in the plexiglass, or are they?
This is just the surround around.
No, I understand it. Are we talking material and color, or just color?
We're just talking about the color, that the yellow is appropriate and can work. We can find it as a workable solution. How many people can find the yellow as a workable solution? And how many cannot?
You mean how many of the board members find the proposed yellow color acceptable? As proposed.
Yes.
So how many?
There's two.
Two. Who is it? Kong?
Well,
and Gradine?
Yeah. We're talking color at this point. We're talking
yes.
color.
Right.
Color.
Right.
Yes.
So that fails two.
So there's three people on the board would like to see you turn away from the yellow. And how you approach it, you can come back to the board and tell us.
Okay.
So
we just to remind the board, we just approved a yellow building, very similar to this yellow on Haley Street. The whole building mm-hmm. is yellow, the whole front.
I'm aware of that, and I think it was a different yellow.
It's slightly different.
Is it the
it's
yellow
different.
Material, or is it the yellow color that's causing anxiety?
Well, we haven't voted on the material yet.
Oh.
For me, it's a combination of the color and the material. I just think the building is very traditional, and it's a very glitzy element. It feels at odds with the building. If it were, I think, potentially, I'm on the fence, if it were a beautiful, smooth steel trowel plaster in the Santa Barbara style, I think the yellow possibly could work.
Well, that's what I said.
Yeah, and I think exactly what you said. And again, I'm on the fence.
And to me, I really don't think building that traditional. It's have a tile roofing, but it's not really a Spanish. It's not a too traditional building either. It's a transitional
70s
Mediterranean hybrid. Mediterranean.
It's a bank building.
It's a bank building.
It for me, the material and color combination feels too flashy for this style of building.
So, can
and
we have another straw
that
vote?
In combination for me
yeah.
personally?
Yeah, let's clarify that.
If the color was toned down just a bit, mm-hmm. and it was plaster, how many board members would possibly find it acceptable?
Yeah, I'd have to see it, but yeah, I think it's in the realm of possibility.
So there's gives you some direction.
Okay, hope that didn't help. I hope that helped.
Not everybody voted.
If three people voted in favor, that means there's two people that did not vote in favor.
So three voted in favor of toning the yellow down and in plaster instead of metal.
Yeah.
Did you get that?
And that's up to you and the workability aspects of...
Unfortunately, I don't have any options. It's either yes or no in my world, so...
Oh. Yeah, the bank had a certain standard, you know, they...
I don't have variances on that
yet, so... Okay. Let's formulate a motion, and let's make it... we can make it a two-week continuance if you think you can update the drawings and get back to us, or we can make it an indefinite back to full board.
How long do you think it will take?
We can make it indefinite, or a two-week, and then if you can't make it within a week, call staff, and they'll postpone you on the other 2 weeks. Mm-hmm. Or we can make it a four-week continuance.
Two.
So this would be for a two-week continuance if someone wants to.
Will you be mailing those plans in?
I'll email them.
No.
You want me to do that?
You can email them to a reprographic task here and have them. Yeah.
Well, no, I'll send them to you. I didn't know if you wanted to take a look at them first.
I understand, but I would be, if you want to come back in 2 weeks, I would need to know a week from tomorrow. I would need to have the plan. Well, no, you can bring the plans with you. Actually, if it's a 2 week continuance, you can bring the plans with you.
Okay.
So I don't need to see them.
Yeah, I can do that.
So 2 weeks, then you think you can have everything ready and return. Okay, very good.
So if we can have someone formulate a motion for
motion
comments.
To continue.
It's a motion to continue
for 2 weeks with the following comments. Number one, to address the color at the ATM machine. Either tone down the yellow or come up with another option. Number two, I think re-look at the planter facing Milpas Street and to make sure that it's workable with the depth that you have now. And you have any comment about the lighting?
I would like integrate the lighting with the architecture.
Okay.
And coordinate the proposed lighting with the site plan.
And photometrics.
And the photometrics that you have proposed.
Time out. Are you guys writing this?
We're writing it all down. Oh. We have a motion. We need someone to second it.
Sorry. I'll second it.
And then we'll have a discussion. Before we take a vote, we'll talk. Second, anything you'd add?
I think your comment about the handrail was a valid one.
Okay.
Wait, what was that again?
Oh,
the handrail.
Look for an opportunity to have handrail with greater character and interest.
And the gate.
And the trash enclosure gate.
And consider adding shade trees to the parking lot. On the south side of the parking lot.
Just for clarification, what we'd be looking for on the gates, that we typically see in Santa Barbara is with a wood finish. So you could still have a steel frame behind it, but applied wood finish.
And then this is just a comment for the app. Well, I'll actually make it a motion. Cut a section at the ATM overhang in relationship to the roof overhang to see if the ATM overhang can be removed and whatever security that was in that overhang can get relocated to the roof overhang. That makes sense? As long as that makes sense, because that's the question. And then
we need to make sure that the secretary can make sense of it. Mm-hmm.
Need to remove the ATM overhang?
Yeah.
Okay.
And yeah, that's good enough. Cool. And then one last comment is study opportunities to add additional landscaping to the facade along the Mason Street elevation, the blank facade?
Yes.
The tall wall?
Mm-hmm. The tall wall along Mason Street. Does anybody want to anything else? Mm-hmm. You want to
just as clarification, not as part of the motion, but and I didn't really follow this discussion very well, but I think it was someone was picking up on this. This could just be a single wall without trying to make it a raised planter. Just be a single wall of 10 inches in dimension with a planter in front, give you a little more planter there, without having to change the dimensions of your ramp or anything.
Let's make that a comment. Don't write that in the motion.
Right.
That sound reasonable?
Yeah. That's good.
So you have an option.
Good suggestion.
Okay.
Anything else before we call for a vote?
That sign package, where's that at? It's just to clarify from what we do on this, when this all goes away, which I will now propose and bring back to you, just the basic surrounds like we have at Anacapa, this also goes away. So the whole pigeon drop thing, this is a package. So okay. When this goes away, it goes away.
Okay.
So that'll help alleviate that.
I thought there was like security cameras or some kind of Mickey Mouse stuff up there.
No, this is just washing this, and because this is non-illuminated in this application, we didn't bring a bright, glaring illumination, which we do in some markets, like in a downtown environment of San Francisco or L.A. or something like that.
That's what I was reading.
Okay. Right. And so now we'll bring those lights up into the existing building. So. Okay.
Which they're already there, I believe.
So that'll help when we see the final drawings.
Okay.
So we can alleviate the pigeon thing and all that. So.
So I'll call for a vote if there's no other discussion. All in favor of the motion?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries, and we'll see you in 2 weeks.
Thank you.
That's on June 9th, right, on a Monday?
It would be on a Monday, yes.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much. We're on to the last item.
Can we take these back with us?
Yeah, we keep one. Okay.
Thank
you. Item 6, we are starting 5 minutes early.
Yeah, unbelievable.
This is a concept review, new item. This is 721 Cliff Drive. I will read the project description because this is the first time we've heard the project. This is a proposal for a new 3-story, 30,000-square-foot classroom and office building to be constructed on the west campus of the Santa Barbara City College. This building will replace existing classroom structures. The building is proposed to have a roof garden. Advisory comments only. Project requires a coastal development permit from the California Coastal Commission.
You want to?
We've reviewed these, so yeah, let's just go with these.
Okay.
No problem.
Before you start, I just want to clarify one thing with staff. This is just like the sign that we reviewed at La Playa Stadium, in which we give our comments and it goes to the Coastal Commission, and
Correct. That's
all we're doing.
Correct. That's it.
So this is kind of like a one-time shot, so we should make sure that when we craft a motion, we're happy with the way the motion is put together, because that'll go on and we might not see it again. I have your name for the record and your presentation.
Yes, my name is Thierry Cassan, architect from Kroger, Benson, Zimmer, Santa Barbara.
Great. So where are we looking? What are we looking at?
All right, let me explain a little. You're probably aware of Santa Barbara City College has two campuses, the East and the West campus. No, this is the East campus with a larger campus, and the other side of Loma Alta Drive, you have the West Campus. Now, our project is on the West Campus and is behind the existing Garvin Theater. I don't know if you all know the theater, this big 4-story building. Now, this is our building. And right now, behind the Garvin Theater, that's the other side, but we have a series of portable buildings. No, our site is exactly the same site as a portable building we're going to remove, and we're going to stop at the existing curb. Now the building will fit right there. It's a 30,000 square feet building, and it's a 3-story building. And I'm going to start with this view. You're going to have a good view. But this is an existing photo of the site. You can see the portable buildings I just mentioned, and this is the back of the Garvin Theater.
We started early. You want to introduce her?
Yes. This is Julie Hendricks from Santa Barbara City College, Director of Facilities.
Okay.
And where I was.
You were talking about this.
Okay, now you can see in the proposed building, and we decide to, it's a pretty large structure. It's a 3-story building, 30,000 square feet. Now the first concept was we need to minimize the impact on the neighborhood. We know we can have a 3-story behind the building because the Garvin is a 4-story building, blank building with no windows, nobody really going to see it. But past the building, we're having a lot of neighbor on Del Mar, No, the first idea was, let's try to step the building and keep a first story, a single story, when the neighbor can see it, and you can see the simulation or the neighbor from Delmar. You can see the view, very less impacted the view. You can see the Garvin Theater. And when we are beyond the building, we can raise up and have a two and step to a three-story. Now, that was the original concept, but you have this big building, you know, located the tallest part, you know, in the back of the tallest existing building, and have the lower, you know, lower building to minimize the ocean view from the neighbor. Now, also to kind of minimize the impact, we were thinking it would be very interesting to provide a roof garden on top of this single building. Now we envision to have this green roof to cover the full single story. We did a series of simulations from all around the campus, and this is a view Del Sol. Del Sol is a street, you know, probably 200 feet above Del Mar, and you can see the building kind of disappearing in existing trees. You can barely see it from the street, and the sky is not really impacted by anything. And this is a view from the entry of the West Campus from Cliff Drive. And again, you can see the impact is very, very minimal. You barely can see the building, and you can see the top of the top floor. We did the same simulation from the other side, from the beach side, and this is a view from Leadbetter Beach, and you don't see the building. The building is the tallest part is located behind this existing Garvin Theater. Now we kind of protecting, you know, the beach, any kind of building from there. And I think we have a series of view from Leadbetter, and you can see, again, you know, we're moving towards the harbor, and you still don't barely see the building. I think you will start to pop somewhere here. Right here, you can see the top of the third floor popping right here, and finally it start to show a little, the east elevation start to show beyond the tree line of a little Bella Beach. Well, I want to talk a little more about the building. Now you can see this is the finished grading plan. Now you can see the bottom floor located, you know, like I said, you know, along the driveway, and taking the same footprint as the existing, you know, and we had to break the building. The building is very long. Now what we decide to break into, we having the single story, step to two story, and we created the main entry right in the middle, and from there you have a three story. And all around we're proposing a bioswale to take care of, with a roof garden and a bioswale to take care of storm drainage. Open circulations. Again, this is a landscape plan. You can see the bioswale with native plant, a few trees. Okay, this is a roof plan. Again, you can see from the existing driveway, you can see of single story roof garden, and the second story and the third story with a main entry in the middle. To maximize the view, we kind of tilted the second and the third story to face the nice view from the harbor and from the city right here. And also we created on the second floor a faculty terrace, and by changing the angle facing the ocean, we kind of bypass the tall Garvin Theater and, and have a very nice ocean view from the second and top floor from this angle. So this angle was just to maximize the view from the building out. Now it's a classroom building on a total of 23 classrooms and 20 faculty offices. And this is the first floor, very simple volume split in two. Again, you have the first story and the step, second story and the third story, with a series of classrooms on the first floor. And you have now the second floor with the angle we try to give to the building to improve the view from the building out. Another, the second floor, we also overhang the second floor above the first floor, and we cover those walkway to access the building using the overhang of the second floor as a little portico to be able to protect the students to enter the building from the. And the third floor is already stacked on top of the second floor with the same number of the classroom.
Great.
One of the strongest element for this building is this is the first building on campus facing the rest of the college. In the past, every building, because of the side, they're facing the ocean. Now they're turning the back to each other. If you walk in City College, you can see the building facing the ocean, but turning the back to each other. This building, because of the Garvin Theater and the angle we gave, we having this eastern elevation facing the East Campus. And I think this was very well needed for the West Campus, because right now it's just back of two buildings, the Business Communication Building and the Garvin Building, with no windows. There is no lights. The students park over there. Is a large parking lot, and it was this lack of direction by a building facing the campus. The student needs this kind of. And Julie, you can add.
We can have you wrap up like in 3 minutes to 4 minutes.
Yes.
Okay. Elevations are great.
Yes. So it's the elevation. This is the elevation. The north elevation. You can see the step. And the main entry, we have also a secondary entry facing this existing parking lot. And continue very quick. This is our southwest. You can really read the step building. And finally, this is a close-up or entry boulevard. You can see the connecting bridge between the two buildings. And we kind of covering this boulevard with this canopy and to provide a thermal shade. And that's it.
Great. Great presentation. Thanks. I will open up public comments. Is there anyone from the public wishing to speak? None. Staff, do you have a comment or does any public letters? Close public comment. Return it back to the board for questions of the applicant. I'm trying to get out of here by 6 o'clock. That's the only reason why I'm being short.
Yeah, I have some questions.
You're up.
Can you tell us about the material of the building a little bit, like the base? Mm-hmm. What's your intention for the base? What's your intention for the skin and the overhang?
Okay. Well, the base, I think we were looking for something strong. You know, you can see it's a very simple volume. And though I think we want to use a Santa Barbara sandstone, a real 2-inch cut stone, to veneer the base of the building. And we also have those square opening, and we're going to have a nice stone lintel and a pretty nice detailing on those windows. The rest of the building is mainly a combination of aluminum curtain wall, and when it's solid, we're using a plaster, 7-8 plaster, and I think all the plaster in the college, it's this white texture plaster, and we're thinking using the same. We probably match the Garvin Theater. A strong element, I think, to break this long building, and I think I introduced this kind of angle in a curtain walls to This was my idea to mimic a little the pier, Santa Barbara Pier. You see those piles? No, not on the pile, it's straight, they're all in angle. There was a, you know, it's right there. You can see from the east elevation. I was trying to mimic a little the Santa Barbara. And we using on the plaster, I'm using this aluminum batten to also match the curtain wall angle. Now you can see how that carry away. Mm-hmm. That carries the curtain wall to a solid by having those aluminum batten. And when we're having those exterior vertical circulation, we also use this aluminum framing, or we omit the glass. Now we have this continuous angle and pattern all along the building, and this is for the second and the third floor. Now, you know, a solid base, I think you deserve to have a very solid and earthy base and a very light and dynamic top floors.
Thank you. Questions?
And the roof is a metal, the big roof, the cantilever.
Okay.
Is it, am I right? It's a metal roofing.
It's a single ply.
A single
energy efficient white. It won't be white, but it's a light gray energy smart. That's the term. Single ply from Twenco, not the full roof. And of course, it's a green roof on a single story.
And it looks like you've tapered the roof to project a very thin edge.
Exactly. Mm. We create this cornice all around, and we taper with some aluminum panel, and it's this little angle to make this overhang a little.
Do you have any other questions?
Is there anything, from what I can see from the entry,
yes.
It looks very unadorned. I mean, there's a gap. You can clearly see it's the entry.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything happening in the paving, or I don't want to trail on to comments, but it just seems very minimal and unadorned.
Yeah, the paving, you can see we color the paving between the two buildings, and the idea was to create a deck. Now we're using stained concrete, or actually integral concrete, integral color concrete, and we're forming bolt form to have this heavy structure, texture, and we kind of have a joint every foot. Look like it's a big white board, and you can see the color. The rest, it's a typical sidewalk, gray concrete with a joint every 5 feet. But between the building, we're having this stronger. And we're also using this aluminum slat ceiling we're having on the sentry under the bridge. And I think we wanted to introduce, it will be aluminum, but we'll have like a wood effect, I think. It's aluminum painted wood. You know what I mean? We cannot use the wood, of course, but I think it's going to warm a little the space.
And these are undulated steel or metal panels?
This is plastic. This is from 3M Form. It is this a Utah company who make this very durable plastic panels, and they suspend it from the structure above with those little stainless steel spider anchorage, and they use those panels to do a bus shelter. You know, it's pretty rigid, and in our case, we want to be off-white. You know, it will be translucent, but it has this white color. We don't want to introduce a color other than the color of the stone and the landscape around.
Questions?
I don't have any questions.
I had one having to do with landscaping. We talked about the building. Anything you're doing to add landscaping, is that a little premature right now? Have you thought about how you're going to integrate landscaping around the building other than the roof garden?
Yeah, we're having this bioswale. No, we're having this...
Any trees being proposed?
We're having a few trees. If you look at the landscape plan, we call for it.
Is it this one? Because it was in one of your photo stems.
Right here.
Okay.
Now, we're having...
What are the bees? Or B and two A's?
The bees are...
Okay. This is them. Are they big or small?
These are very well-sized trees. They're 36-inch box and 48-inch box.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. those bees and they are large. The rest is a very small native plant, drought tolerant, mixed with rocks, forming the bioswale. You can see.
And then the second question is the rooftop garden that's over here. Is it accessible or is it just?
It's accessible for maintenance only.
For maintenance only.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. No.
Those were all my questions. Any other questions from anybody? If not, let's go to comments. Tip, you're up. You're first.
Okay. I think the building has a lot of potential. There's a couple items, a couple things that I'm a little concerned about. Number one is the base, and I understand the idea to make a base really strong to anchor the building. I'm just have a little concern about using the material sandstone putting together the sandstone, the traditional way, the Spanish traditional way of sandstone base, almost really clashing with the building. And I'm just wondering if a concrete base might work a little better or some different kind of materials instead of the sandstone. That's just really something that I'm not sure that will work or not with the massing above. Comment number two about the massing above, it has some really nice element. I think the roof is great. I assume the steel column is nice, the white column supporting the entrance. However, I think the base is once again a little too heavy, the white base, which are two big bands.
Talking about this here.
Yep. That seem to be really weight the building down heavily. And also how it sit on top of the wall, I think that really would be a good detailing. Is that sit on top of the wall. Right now it seems like it's sinking into the concrete, the stone base. So the detail, this detail right around here and how this sit to that, I feel that probably can be cleaned up a little bit to make a little stronger building. And then the third comment is how do you tie the smaller, I know you do that already, and the bigger one has a nice big overhang and the smaller one is almost the glass house with no overhang whatsoever. It's just sitting on top of the wall. So that's another thing that I think that could marry the two, be a little better between the two forms. And I like the way you step the building from the garden to the second story to the third story, which I think it works from all the views. And I think that could be a great addition to the campus. The plaster is another material I'm just debating. Is that would be fine with the glazing system? Because it can be a very clean building, contemporary, but now it's kind of mixed with low Spanish base, and there's nothing Spanish about this building.
Yeah.
These are just comments, and we'll roll them into something later. Anybody in any order?
I'll start next. I think the building is very skillfully placed on the site plan. I think your presentation was excellent. And it's a difficult site because you've got the other building in front of it and it's very long and narrow and you've got constraints. And I think you've eked a lot of excitement and drama as a very long, narrow, linear building and made something really interesting and charming and dynamic. So I think the overall site plan and the building, they have a lot of very, very good qualities about it. I think the angle that you've chosen to face the ocean makes a lot of sense. Breaking the building in the center, I think, is the correct way to go. And certainly the stepping works very, very well. A few comments. I think I agree with Tip. I was thinking to myself that this lower band feels a little heavy. And there is that kind of tension that maybe is unresolved. Is it sitting on the plinth or kind of eating into the plinth? Maybe there's a different way to resolve that. I think the entry is somewhat obvious. I think it's strong with the column. I think there may be something else that cues you to where the entry is. Maybe it's a tad wider. Maybe there's a canopy jutting out. I think it's almost there. It's a little unclear. It's not unclear. It just feels like more drama or more interest or something at the entry might enhance it better. I think I agree with Tip's comment that the interplay between the two buildings may not be completely resolved. Maybe there's more of a dialogue between them, and like Tip suggested, maybe that happens with the canopies. they're communicating, but it may not be quite the same language yet. But on the whole, I think the angles that you've chosen matching the pier, that's a charming analogy. I really love that. I think this could be a very interesting, exciting building for Santa Barbara, and I hope it gets built.
Come on, I'll just jump in order. Incredible building. I mean, you've got a lot of neat stuff that's working here. I'll be slightly different than Tip in the sense that the Rock is a great solution, just because when you look at the campus from the beach, City College is on a stone block. It's the Acropolis of Santa Barbara, with the Garvin Theater not looking very handsome. So having the stone here, I always appreciate this intersection here, the thickness of the white band. I mean, I'm not that particular whether it's engaged. I actually like that engagement because it's tying itself to the earth, yet here's the stone base. So the stone is something that I think is a strong concept that you have here in relationship to Santa Barbara. What I didn't pick up on, but I'm glad Tip mentioned it, was the roof overhangs and trying to make this. You don't have to take this exact thing, but have a little bit of an overhang over here and a little bit of something over here to sort of say we're of the same family, yet we're brothers, or, you know, we're, you know, whatever it is. But right now they're a little bit too dissimilar. I was, you know, great for the trees that are being planted here. If there's an I know you have two buildings that are here. If this is always going to be an island, then maybe you can put a couple of trees in here to sort of give some scale to this is a very large building, and that's why I was wondering what the size of those trees were that were being planted here, sycamores or something, to sort of have some landscaping of significant scale next to this building. But it's an incredible building. Kudos for angling it, taking advantage of the view, and providing public space in there for the students this direction, the faculty in an outdoor terrace looking that way. Wonderful, the way we Santa Barbara's like to design buildings to fit our site, and it is a tight site. So it's a great building with some minor architectural tweaking just to make it that much better. Oh, and one last thing I didn't ask you, but I assume all mechanical equipment won't be seen from the pedestrian level.
That's correct.
And that just together.
Yeah. And now for something completely different. So of course we have our own viewpoints on it. I think it's a really nice design. It's a really fine design. And I like the stone base. I like, as Scott mentioned, the site placement, the angling of the building. Those are really strong. I think this could really be a magnificent break between the buildings. I'll tell you what my reservation about it. And like if you look at that close up, is just the way these two this very very strong announcement of the entrance canopy. Break between the building. It's the way this is interacting with this. It's like just some integration. Maybe the two need to connect. Maybe there needs to be, I don't know. This just seems like an unresolved area right there. That's my only issue with that. Otherwise, I think this is a magnificent way to break up the mass of the building, and it's going to be a very exciting space to be in. So I think that's brilliant. I love the stone as well. I'm with Paul on that. Here's my one take that no one's mentioned yet. And I also think, you know, the way this is different, but picks up the window detail, I think that works really well. This is a different building. It's a distinct building from this, but it also relates with this very playful, you know, arrangement of vertical elements. So I think it's fine other than this kind of one unresolved connecting area, in my view. The other thing I would say is that because this is so strong and a wonderful aspect, that to carry it through on the siding to me seems unnecessary. It seems that this could just be plain plaster with the windows. But then, you know, one thing I also really like is the way you have done some playfulness here with the heights. So I could see, you know, picking up that with the windows along there as opposed to keeping this. Because at a certain point, it's just like it starts to get a little bit overwhelming, I think, on that big of a space. So that's my suggestion, is that this could be plainer and finding a way to bring in play with the windows as opposed to just this very strong horizontal. That's it.
I think the design is excellent. I agree with the comments, the positive comments regarding the stone. I think it's a really nice element, and it brings, it humanizes the building and brings it down to pedestrian scale. I love what you did with the windows in the stone walls. I love the playfulness of that. Appreciate the sizes of the trees, and I think the planting plan looks great. Also appreciate the use of the swale and the green roof. I think those are both great calls. I am somewhat concerned with the starkness or largeness of this elevation in relationship to the adjacent parking lot. So if there's anything that we can do, even though it's not part of this plan set, to maybe they're just not shown on this rendering, but if we can address some larger trees somewhere on this side of the building within the parking lot, if that makes sense. It doesn't look like you'll be able to fit anything up against the building itself, but maybe, you know, in the adjacent areas would be helpful for that elevation. And otherwise, I think it's a great project. Good.
So how many more seconds do we have left?
7 minutes. Staff would probably want to hear some type of a comment on whether or not there are any impacts to views from down below, public views, looking up.
Based upon the photo simulations that were being shown, the impact will be minimal. Mm-hmm. Does the board concur with that?
Yes.
So that's the response to that question.
Can I have just a quick ask out the board for a quick straw vote on the stone? It seemed like everyone likes the stone.
I think I agreed with you, Chip, that a different stone pattern of running
How about a different pattern instead of doing a hexagon?
It's kind of a flagstone, oversized flagstone that you would see on a flat surface. It's not like stacked stone, from what I can see, but this is just the CAD pattern.
Or running bond, a different, use the traditional materials, but use it in a more modernistic way to go with the building.
I was actually thinking he can't go with small pieces because the building's so big. He's got to go with big building pieces.
Yeah, I agree. Like a big stone base in the building in Italy, you know, Florence, a big, heavy base, but it's not stacking, running bond instead of...
You're looking for Ashlar instead of random.
Huh?
You're looking for something like an Ashlar instead of the random
cut. Yeah, instead of doing as I said, the beautiful. Every time I look at it, I just realize that somehow the stone just.
I want to say that for this review, since we're not going to see it again, that we make that a comment. The architect files it away. We can tell the Coastal Commission, but they really won't care. So, but it's a valid point from another architect's perspective, is that the actual detailing of this at one point. Is something but he's got bigger issues on his mind right now.
I think in terms of big picture items, this project does everything right.
The only thing I would concur with Courtney is that if there's a landscape island right here at the parking, we can put a couple of trees here. And if we don't ask for them now, they won't get planted. You've got two buildings here, and you were planting. That's why I was asking about the size of these trees, because this looks kind of dinky. But she said they're bigger trees, so... I think it is important to have some trees here in this landscape island, and that she was saying it looks stark from the parking lot. And that's something that would be beneficial to the placement of this building on the site. So if we can fold some of this stuff up, or I can make a motion. Comments? You have them all written down?
You gave them to us. That's it.
Staff is wonderful. Thank you very much, and you're more than welcome to come back again if you want.
We don't mind.
And with that, we will end the meeting.
Thank you very much.
That's yours.
Thank you. If I never had a sin,
loving you. Whatever else I may do, my love for you will live till time itself is through. I'll never stop wanting you, and when forever is through, my heart will beat the way it does each time we meet. The night doesn't question the stars that appear in the skies. So why should I question the stars that appear in my eyes? Of this I'm more than just sure, my love will last and endure. I'll never, no, I'll never stop loving you. That appear in my eyes. Of this I'm more than just sure, my love will last and endure. I'll never, no, I'll never stop loving you.
Small hotel with a wishing well. I wish that we were there together. There's a bridal suite, one room bright and neat, complete for us to share together. Looking through the window, you can see a distant steeple. Not a sign of people who wants people. When the steeple bell says good night, sleep well, we'll thank the small hotel together. Thank you. Looking through the window, you can see a distant steeple. Not a sign of people who once people. When the steeple bell says good night, sleep well, we'll thank the small hotel. We'll creep into our little shell, and we will thank the small hotel. Together, let there be wind, an occasional